Welcome back to my ASMR channel. Thank you so much for being here. For today's video, I will be painting this adorable little birdhouse while softly speaking to you. I'm just gonna ramble. There's not really anything particular I'll be talking about, but hopefully by the end of the video you'll be fast asleep. I will be sipping on as I talk to you. Okay, let's get started painting this. Also, I apologize if you can hear my dog sleeping in the background. He is breathing, and if you hear breathing sounds, that is him. Here are my paints. I haven't even really thought or given it thought on how to paint my birdhouse, but I know I want it to be light colors, so I definitely want this blue. So this is cobalt blue. Okay. I think I also want white and orange. I need more colors, I'll just grab them. So I'm just gonna go ahead and squeeze out some paint. Lemon yellow. It's hard to say that fast. Lemon yellow. Some of this. Oh, this one's not been used yet. Okay. That one's pretty strong. I don't think I'm gonna need a lot. Okay. gonna add some the blue to make it just more pastel. Some to the orange, and then just some white by itself. This is some of my brushes. Go ahead and mix the blue and the white. Before I do that, actually, I want a sip of my tea. The tea I'm drinking today is Moroccan mint tea from Trader Joe's with some honey and some lemon. That's how I like it. Okay. Let's get started. Go ahead and mix this white and blue. Such a pretty light blue color. Okay. Microphone so you can hear the sounds. That should be good enough though. So, my plan, I think, is to make this part this color, and then we'll go from there. I'm not sure what I want to do. To just paint. It's always been one of my favorite things to do. I apologize. I really hope it's not a problem. The breathing in the background. So, how have you been? What is going on in your life? I feel like this ASMR channel has really grown on me, and I've been really enjoying it, and I just want to make sure not to stop doing this because I enjoy it. And that would be a shame to stop doing something you enjoy. So, thank you all of you for being here, for subscribing. It helps me know that other people are enjoying this as well. I have a lot of ideas, and I would love to see what works with you guys. Honestly, though, in my opinion, my dog's sleeping sounds are the most cutest thing ever. So hopefully you find them cute too. Sometimes I think about like just making an ASMR video of just his sounds because it's so adorable. Everything he does is adorable. I need more white. I should say I need more white mixed with blue. A lot more of this color because I already ran out of what I mixed. But isn't that such a pretty color? I'm thinking about adding a design to it. If I try to add detail, I'm gonna mess it up. So, we'll see how confident or brave I am if I'm able to do the detail at the end. I think like flowers would look pretty, but yeah, like I said, I don't want to ruin it. So, I'm gonna mix some more. I'm just gonna put like a whole bunch more of these colors since I ran out so quickly. That might have been too much blue, but who cares? I want to read to you what the Wikipedia definition is of ASMR while I paint this. So, it says here on Wikipedia. So, I'm looking, I have my phone like right in front of me, right there, and I'm just gonna read what Wikipedia says about ASMR. So, ASMR stands for Autonomous Sensory Meridian Response. It's an experience characterized, I should say, by a static-like feeling or tingling sensation on the skin that typically begins on the scalp and moves down the back of the neck and the upper spine. You know, this isn't what the Wikipedia says, but I have a question for you guys to answer in the comments below. Just let me know if you want, whether you listen to ASMR for the sensation that it gives, or for the relaxation that it gives, or to sleep, or all three. I use it for all three. And I have been for about 5 years now. That's when I discovered ASMR. About 5 years ago. Okay, back to the reading. Signifies the subjective experience of a quote-unquote low-grade euphoria, characterized by a combination of positive feelings and a distinct static-like tingling sensation on the skin. It is most commonly triggered by specific auditory or visual stimuli, and less commonly by intentional attention. I wonder what it means by intentional attention control. Like, someone trying to do ASMR to you? I mean, I wonder if it's talking about how, like, I can't stand mouth sounds in real life. But, and I can't stand eating sounds in real life. Oh, shoot. But, I can listen to it. And I know that's the same case for a lot of people. It's so interesting how it works through video, but not in real life. In that aspect. I'm sure, like, the paint I put over this will cover it, but I'm just trying to get it off. Okay. The next category on the wiki page is called name, so I'm guessing this is about how it was named ASMR. I don't know. Let's read it. Prior to the social consensus that led to what is now the ubiquitous adoption of the term, other names were proposed and discussed at a number of locations, including the steady health form. The Society of Sensationalists Yahoo group and the unnamed feeling blog. That's so cool to know. Proposed formal names included auditory induced head orgasm, attention induced euphoria, sorry for taking breaks from reading, I get distracted by my own, like by painting, and I'm like so focused, you know, in painting, that I forget about the reading. Okay. Oh, and attention-induced observant euphoria. While colloquial terms in usage included brain massage, head tingle, brain tingle, spine tingle, and brain orgasm. Autonomous, spontaneous, self-governing, with or without control. That probably refers to how, like, we can't control it, I guess. Sensory. Pertaining to the senses or sensation. And meridian, signifying a peak, climax, or point of highest development. Response, referring to an experience triggered by something external or internal. Oh, that definitely suits, like, it definitely does apply to what ASMR is. Like, I like the definition behind each word. And I feel like it does relate. And then it says, Alan verified in 2016 interview that she purposely selected these terms because they were more objective, comfortable, and clinical than alternative terms for the sensation. I agree. She selected the word meridian to replace the word orgasm, and she said she had found a dictionary that defined meridian as a point or period of highest development, greatest prosperity, or the like. What else does it say? The term and autonomous sensory meridians response its initials, ASMR, were adopted by contributors to online discussions and those reporting and commentating on the phenomenon.
That's cool.
I want to try to make this a muted brown gray. Need to add black to that. Let's see how it looks. Oh yeah, I'm gonna add a little bit more. Should be good. Hopefully this doesn't look bad. Okay. So, this category is called sensation and triggers. Sensation, the subjective experience, sensation, and perceptual phenomenon now widely identified by the term autonomous sensory meridian response, is described by some of those susceptible to it as akin to a mild electrical current or the carbonated bubbles in a glass of champagne. Additionally, ASMR is often triggered by exposure to specific audio and video. Such media may be specially made with the specific purpose of triggering ASMR, originally created for other purposes and later discovered to be effective as a trigger of the experience. Stimuli that can trigger ASMR, as reported by those who experience it, include the following. Listening to a softly spoken or whispering voice. Listening to quiet, repetitive sounds resulting from someone engaging in a mundane task, such as turning the pages of a book. Watching someone attentively execute a mundane task, such as preparing food. Also loudly chewing, crunching, slurping, or biting foods, drinks, or gum, receiving personal attention, initiating the stimulus through conscious manipulation without the need for external video or audio triggers, listening to tapping, typically nails, onto surfaces such as plastic, wood, metal, etc. Hand movements, especially one onto one's face. What else is missing? I want to make this a dark red brown, and I want to make this white, and I want to make the inside green. Oh, you know what? I put yellow on my thing, and now I don't know if I'm going to use it for anything. You know what? I think I'll make this yellow. So, next category is whispering triggers. I'm just gonna make the... I'm trying to decide if I should make the picket fence yellow or white. I'll decide later. Let's make this dark. Nick Davis and Emma Barrett discovered that whispering was as an effective trigger for 75% of the 475 subjects who took part in an experiment to investigate the nature of ASMR. And that statistic is reflected in the popularity of intentional ASMR videos. Yellow to that. I mean yellow. Red. Crimson.